This is a problem of improper integration. The given problem is integration 0 to infinity x to the power p minus 1 dx by 1 plus x, which is convergent if four options are given: p less than 0, p greater than 1, p less equal to 1, or 0 less p less than 1. Now we have to find only the interval of p in which the integration is convergent. Split this integration into two integrations as I is equal to integration 0 to infinity x raised to p minus 1 dx by 1 plus x is equal to integration 0 to 1 x raised to p minus 1 dx by 1 plus x plus 1 to infinity x raised to p minus 1 dx by 1 plus x. Let this is I1 and this is I2. This integration I1 is of the form integration a to b, and this integration I2 is of the form integration b to infinity or a to infinity. We here use total four tests. We discuss the four tests one by one. The first test is mu test. Which is mu test? Integration a to b dx by x minus a equal to the power mu, having only point of infinite discontinuity is x equal to a, that is the lower limit. Then this integration is convergent if and only mu, this is mu, the value of mu is less than 1. This is the first test. And we use in this type of integration, integration a to infinity. This is very useful test for comparison test. A to infinity, here must be a greater than 0. Dx by x to the power mu is convergent only if mu greater than 1. These two type of test look like same, but the test is different and the integration be different. Here the integration range is finite, here the integration range is infinite. Also a must be greater than 0. This test converge if mu less than 1, and this test converge if mu greater than 1. Now we go to the third test. This test for second integration, I. Here the integration is of the form integration a to infinity. Here fx and gx both the positive function, such that limit x tends to infinity fx by gx, this is equal to L. Now this test depends only on the value of L. If L is non-zero finite, that is not equal to 0, not equal to infinity, then we say that fx and gx both convergent or divergent together. Both convergent and divergent together. If If m equal to 0, the value of the limit m, this is m equal to 0, then we say that if integration a to infinity gh dx is convergent, then integration a to infinity fx is also convergent. And third test, if a equal to infinity, then integration a to infinity gh dx is divergent, then a to infinity fx dx is also divergent. This is the limit form of convergence test. Here we have to find the convergence of integration a to infinity fx dx, and we compare by another integration of the form a to infinity g. Now we find the limit fx by gx. Here we get fx and here we get gx, and the limit is L, then three tests can appear. And another limit form of comparison test we also used here, which is this. This is look like same, but the integration are in the finite range a to b. Also here a to b, and here also a to b, here also a to b, and another are same. Okay, here if a equal to 0, then integration a to b gh dx is convergent only if this is convergent, then integration a to b is also convergent. Similarly, if a equal to infinity, then a to b gh dx is divergent, then integration a to b fx dx is also divergent. This is the another limit form of convergence test, where both the limit are finite. Right? So we use these four tests to solve this problem. I1 is integration 0 to 1 x to the power p minus 1 by 1 plus x dx. Now if p minus 1 greater equal to 0, then 0, 1 and no point in between 0, 1 is an infinite discontinuity of this function. So this integration is proper. That means convergent. Proper integration means convergent. Now we consider the case only when p minus 1 less than 0, that is when p less than 1. And in this case, we take fx equal to x to the power p minus 1 by 1 plus x, and gx equal to 1 by x to the power 1 minus p. Right? Then both fx and gx are positive, that is greater than 0, in 0, 1. 0, 1. Also, limit x tends to 0, fx by gx, this is equal to limit x tends to 0, 1 by 1 plus x, this means 1 not equal to 0, not equal to infinity. So by the comparison test of limit form, we say that fx and gx both are convergent or divergent. And we know that integration 0 to 1 gx dx, this is equal to integration 0 to 1 1 by x to the power 1 minus t dx, that is integration 0 to 1 1 by x minus 0 to the power 1 minus t dx. This is of the form integration a to b dx by x minus a to the power negative. And this integration is convergent only if mu less than 1, that is 1 minus p less than 1, that is p greater than 0. Right? So here we get p less than 0 and p less than 1 and we get t greater than 0. Also here if p greater than equal to 1, then the integration is proper. So we say that I1 is convergent if p greater than 0. Now we consider the integration I2, integration 1 to infinity x to the power p minus 1 by 1 plus x dx. Here we consider fx, this is equal to 1 by x to the power 1 minus p into 1 plus x and this is equal to 1 by x to the power 2 minus p into 1 by x plus 1 and let g x equal to 1 by x to the power 2 minus p. Now limit x tends to infinity fx by gx is also 1 by infinity plus 1, this means 1 by 1 equal to 1. And we know that integration 1 to infinity gx dx, this means integration 1 to infinity dx by x to the power 2 minus p is convergent only if we already discussed 4 tests, only if 2 minus p greater than 1. 2 minus p greater than 1, this means p less than 1. Okay, and from this test, limit form of comparison test, we say that integration 1 to infinity fx and integration 1 to infinity gx both converge and diverge together. So integration 1 to infinity fx dx, that is I2, is convergent only if p less than 1, right? Only if p less than 1. So for I1 we get the condition of convergence p greater than 0, and for I2 we get the condition of convergence p less than 1. So for this integration, 1 is an exponent. This is 0 less b less 1. This is the answer. Thank you. Thank you for watching.